My lab is working on two species of bats called Leptonycteris. It's a long-nosed Mexican nectar bat. This research initiative started in April of 2016 when Bat Conservation International called together a group of researchers from Mexico and the U.S. that work on Leptonycteris nivalis, and we formed the Nivalis Conservation Network. Nycteris nivalis is an endangered species, and it's also important, it has economic value because it's actually the bat that pollinates the tequila plant. When the bats migrate out from Mexico, the main thing that really initiates their migration is the floration of this corridor of agave and columnar cactus, which have the main food item that they eat. They have long noses, kind of like a hummingbird, if you can think of a fuzzy hummingbird with wings. They migrate from northern and central Mexico all the way up to the southern U.S., and they get up to New Mexico and in several places in Arizona and Texas. Just recently, my graduate student Scarlett Sellers and I, we went down to Mexico, and there's a cave down there called Cueva del Infierno, and it's a Leptonycteris cave, a known Leptonycteris cave. And we met up with there other researchers that came from, that work in Texas, and other researchers that work for Bat Conservation International. And we met up with some researchers down in Mexico from the Universidad de Nuevo León and some from UNAM, which is the main one in Mexico City. And our goal to go down there was to mark a bunch of Leptonycteris, but also to learn more about the marking technique. We use this marking technique called pit tagging, where you insert these little pits under the skin with an injector thing. And since this is an endangered species and requires special permits, we wanted to be trained by the best. The director of Bat Conservation International, Winifred Frick, she was there to train everybody on the pit tagging. When we have the bats marked with this pit tag, each of the researchers has a particular cave area where we know the Leptonycteris is. And we put this antenna, it's called a rope antenna. It's a big rope antenna, like a cord, that you put around the entrance and the exit of the cave. So having these bats marked, and we're all making large efforts in each of our respective areas, marking a lot of bats, we're hoping that we'll get a bat that flies into my cave, for example, that's in New Mexico, that was marked down there in Nuevo León or something. So the idea of having this collaboration between us all is to document arrival and departure dates, and also to document movement patterns so we can find out where they're actually coming from. One of my students, Scarlett Sellers, her thesis is focused on the diet of Leptonycteris here in New Mexico. These bats eat mainly agave, and there are not that many agaves. I mean, there are agave in New Mexico, but not a lot, and there aren't any columnar cactus in the area where these bats are. There's a lot of columnar cactus in Arizona, but not necessarily in New Mexico. And one of my students, Rachel Birch, she's modeled the availability of food resources across the landscape so that we can recognize areas where we should find Leptonycteris, and this will help us know areas that we should look more carefully, look for caves, look for roosting areas. Locally, we've received funding from TNE, which is a nonprofit organization that funds ecological research. A lot of students from NMSU get funding through them. And we've also been funded by the BLN, the local office. They've actually helped us with the equipment. They helped us get the equipment, and it's on loan, but we can use it wherever we need it to do our research on Leptonycteris.
Eye on Research is a production of New Mexico State University.